Up until now, if you wanted to get two wireless lavalier microphones into one camera, your options have been pretty limited. Mostly, well, you've just had to have two systems and mount two receivers on your camera. And this is much easier with some products than it is with others. For example, we use the Sennheiser AVX kits for these videos, which just slot straight into an XLR port. But two systems of these, although they are well worth investing in, will set you back a decent amount of money. Plus, if you're using a smaller camera without XLRs, like a mirrorless camera, then mounting any two receivers, even the AVX or the tiny Rode Wireless Go, just gets much more complicated and awkward. It all gets much easier and simpler when you can sync two transmitters into one receiver. Now, the most popular option for this so far has probably been the Sony system, which is very, very good, but it comes in at an even higher price point than the two AVX systems that we mentioned. So, when we first saw this, the Lark 150 from Holyland, Holyland's first entry into the world of audio products, we were very intrigued. This is an extremely small and affordable two-channel audio system. They don't actually even sell a single channel option. It's a kit with two transmitters and one receiver, a charging case, two included lavalier mics, and a cable pouch. And the entire kit is really quite nicely designed and well thought out. So first up, let's take a little look at the transmitters. These are tiny and very simple. There's only one button here on the side, which is a mute button, and if you hold it down, it's a power button as well. Although you don't really use that for power, because inside the charging case, they sync together, and then as you take it out the charging case, it turns on and it turns off when you put it back in the charging case. They weigh only 20 grams, and so are going to be incredibly easy and unobtrusive for your talent to wear or have in their pocket. There's a built-in microphone on the top, or a 3.5mm jack to connect a lav mic with. Now the dual receiver looks very different. There's two large physical dials for controlling the levels of each channel of audio, which you can push in to mute each transmitter, and then in the center, there's a screen to show the battery life, levels, and status of each unit. On this one, there is a dedicated power button so that you can keep it on your camera and not be draining the battery. Plus, there's a headphone socket. You should use the one in the camera, of course, wherever possible, but having one on the receiver is very useful indeed for troubleshooting and for peace of mind, or if your camera doesn't actually have a headphone port, of course. There's then a 3.5mm line out on the other side to connect to your camera and a clip along the bottom. Now this clip is exactly the same size as a Colchi mount, so attaching it to your camera is incredibly simple. You just slide it on and it stays there. Over this 3.5mm cable, the sound can be sent in a couple of different ways. In mono mode, the audio will be replicated on the left and the right channels, whether you're using one transmitter or two. Great for fast-paced work and easy edit, and for solo speakers. But for interviews with two speakers, you're probably going to want to be using stereo mode. This puts the sound from one transmitter onto the left channel and the other on the right, so in post-production you can just split them up, separate those tracks, and control them each independently. The third option is a safety track. In this mode, the left channel is a mono mix of both transmitters, while the right channel is the same, but it's recorded 6 dB lower so that you can recover any unexpected loud noises. Great for journalism or anything uncontrolled like that. Perhaps the bit that really sets the Lark 150 apart from the competition, though, in my opinion, is the charging case. Now, this isn't a new idea, of course. I'm sure most of you have wireless headphones like these AirPods, for example, and it's the exact same idea. The case itself keeps the units themselves charged so that whenever you need them, they will always be at full battery, though. The Holyland one, though, has a few other tricks up its sleeve. It syncs the units together when inside the case, and it turns them on when you take them out. So by the time you've taken one out of the case and actually handed it over to your talent, they've turned on, they've scanned all the frequencies available, they've picked the best one, and just started working, all without you having to do anything at all. Another nice touch is that the screen on the receiver knows when it's inside the charging case, and if you just press one of these buttons here on it, it will show the charging status of everything, including the case. This case seems like a small little thing at first, but it's a huge part of why the Lark 150 feels so easy and seamless to use. It's really convenient. Now, the batteries that this case are charging are fixed and built into each unit. The transmitters last 4.5 hours, and the receiver lasts 7.5 hours. The charging case itself, which is charged through a USB port on the back, holds enough battery power to charge the whole lot 2.5 times over. From flat, the transmitters take 1.5 hours to charge, and the receiver takes 2 hours, and the case itself takes 2.5. Now, I normally don't go into quite so much detail on the battery life and the charge time of units like this, but because there is only the built-in battery, it's quite important to know. In fact, this is the area that I've seen criticized the most online from the Lark 150, and that's completely understandable. If you run one of these transmitters for longer than 4.5 hours without stopping, the battery will run out, and there's nothing you can do about that. You can't swap the battery out for a fresh one, you can't plug in a charging cable and carry on using it. You're just out of luck, and it needs to go back into the case to be charged. So I think an important part of deciding whether or not the Lark 150 is the product or not for you is deciding how likely that is to happen to you in your work. The units are charged up while in the charging case, so as long as you keep that case charged, all of the individual bits will be fully charged and ready to go whenever you need them. So really, you just have to look at the work you do and decide if you're going to use them for longer than 4.5 hours at once. If you're charging your clients a day rate and you regularly need to be able to do an entire work day, interviewing person after person the whole day long, well, you're going to be better off with a higher end system where you can swap the batteries out as needed. But if you do anything that happens in shorter little bursts, so journalism or corporate in-house videos like the ones we do here, for example, you should be fine. Luckily, it doesn't take me, believe it or not, over 4.5 hours to film these piece-to-cameras for these videos. So the battery life of the Lark 150 for us would be completely fine. So let's now quickly have a listen to how it sounds. And for comparison, we're going to throw into the mix the Rode Wireless Go, which is perhaps the biggest competitor for the Lark 150, plus our higher-end Sennheiser AVX system. We also have different lav mics, which will have a huge impact on what the audio sounds like, a much bigger impact than the transmitters themselves, so do keep that in mind. Let's first listen to the audio recorded from the built-in microphone. This is the Lark 150 with its wind protector on, one here on the front of my top. And this is the Rode Wireless Go with its wind protection on, clipped in the same place. And as a little side note, I do much prefer the wind protector that comes with the Lark 150. It's just much more secure and it stays in place better than the one that comes with the Wireless Go. Whenever possible though, it is well worth wearing a lav mic. This is the Lark 150 with the lav mic that comes with the kit. And this is the Rode Wireless Go with their Rode Lavalier Go microphone. Now this doesn't come with the Rode Wireless Go, remember, you have to buy it separately. Now this is the kit we normally use for these videos, the Sennheiser AVX with the MKE Essentials microphone. But remember, the microphone itself will make a huge difference to what the audio sounds like. So now this is the Lark 150 again, but with the Sennheiser MKE Essentials microphone. And now this is the Lark 150 with the Rode Lavalier Go. And I think both of these mics do sound better than the lav mic which Holyland bundle with the Lark 150. With tests like these, we do have to remember the costs of the units. As of the time of filming this, the Lark 150 costs pretty much exactly the same as buying two sets of the Rode Wireless Go. So, if you're happy using the included lav mics, you do save a decent amount of money by going with the Lark 150 because the Lark 150 comes with two lav mics, whereas the Wireless Go's don't. And if you want to upgrade those lav mics, then you're paying pretty much exactly the same whether you go with the Lark 150 or two sets of the Rode Wireless Go. But remember, if you go with the Lark 150, you will have those two spare backup lav mics, just in case you ever need them. So all in all, considering this is Holyland's first ever audio product, I've been really quite impressed with the Lark 150. If you know that you regularly need two transmitters and you work with small mirrorless cameras doing fast-paced interviews and short-form content like we do here, the Lark 150 could just be the best budget option out there for you. But I do think you should upgrade the lav mics if you can afford to. So, let me know what you think of the Lark 150 in the comment section, and if you want to buy one for yourself or any of the other products we've spoken about here, just head over to proav.co.uk. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.